Lenny's there. Hey, Lenny. And Jim. Hey, guys. Well, I'm still using paper because I wasn't able to get all the stuff. Didn't take the time to get the my foot pedal thing working for this week. Time just disappears on us. But anyways, so it's not a huge number of... holy mackerel, there's 5 people watching now. Thanks. See how it goes. We got a few minutes yet before everybody's here. Hi, Mary. Thank you for joining us from the upper peninsula. Barb, thank you. I hope you got a tonic in hand because God knows you're gonna need it after listening to this one tonight. Thanks, Mary. I don't know if I'm channeling Willie Nelson or what, even though I'm not playing a Willie Nelson song tonight. I had somebody tell me the other day that my beard was looking too raggedy and that I needed to trim it up, which, you know, Santa can't do that. So this was the next best thing. Speaking of, on the other hand, while we're still, we have 1 more minute before people come in. Hello, Diane's waving at me from the other room. I actually had to go and do a Santa photo shoot this last week. It was kind of weird. So I'm doing a Christmas in July at one of the local breweries, and the owner asked me to come out. Good choice, Barbara. The owner asked me to come out, and she took a bunch of pictures over there for a photo shoot. So when that goes up, we'll try to, let's see if everybody can see that. You know, so you got something to throw darts at or whatever. For joining, it's 6:30 on the dot. We'll go ahead and get started. We have horrendous thunderstorms going on in the area, so if you hear anything in the background like that, or if the lights go off, we lose power. I'm working off of my cell phone, so we should be able to, despite popular demand, continue to be able to broadcast. Oh crap, I'm on Wi-Fi, but if the Wi-Fi kicks out, I'll switch to cellular, so I'm okay. So anyways, the theme for tonight was supposed to be TV shows, and let me tell you, that's a lot tougher than you might think it is. I had to pick out a number of ones of the shows that I was somewhat familiar with and knew the tunes. There's a gazillion of them to pick from, and the thing that is weird is that the TV shows are all pretty, the songs are actually pretty complicated. And hey, Kurt, thanks for coming. The songs are fairly complicated because they wanted to make them catchy and unique so that you would remember them, and obviously they do. So I didn't get all of them. Kurt, I did not get The Courtship of
Eddie's father.
Eddie's father, sorry. Couldn't remember what it was. I had to watch some YouTube videos to remember it, and I just didn't have time to squeak that in there today. But who knows? There may be a part deux coming to this later on. So Lenny says they're having thunderstorms in Melbourne, Florida, too. But that's not unusual for Melbourne, Florida. So I had a different hat. It was more of a the TV theme hat. Made me look like Wilson from Home Improvements. But it kind of covered up my eyes a little bit too much. And so decided to wear my patriotic Civil War Union kepi. And we'll take it from there. All right. So this is one that we'll go ahead and get started into this. Hey, Paul, thanks for joining. Once we get going, I won't be able to look at the screen too much and see who's there. Lenny was a better roadie than Diane is.
He must pay her better.
Yeah, I'm sure he pays her better. Because I don't pay you shit. Right. I give you shit, but I don't pay you shit. Okay. All right. F Troop. That would have been a good one, too. And I actually thought about it a little bit, but I'm not sure how well that plays on the ukulele. So let's see if you guys get this one. And sing along, join me. I can't hear you anyways. Bud, hey, Bud. Welcome. I hope Lisa's sitting with you. All right, here we go. Just sit right back and you'll hear a tale of a fateful trip that started from this tropic port aboard this tiny ship. The mate was a mighty sailing man, skipper brave and sure. 5 passengers set sail that day for a 3-hour tour, a 3-hour tour. The weather started getting rough, the tiny ship was tossed. If not for the courage of the fearless crew, the minnow would be lost. The ship set ground on the shore of this uncharted desert town. The dog just hit it. The ship set ground on the shore of this charted desert isle, with Gilligan, the skipper too, the millionaire and his wife, the movie star, the professor and Marianne, here on Gilligan's Isle. All right, sorry about the wobble in there. My three-legged, crippled German Shepherd banged into my new music stand, so that's why his name is Trip. He can't help himself. All right, for those of you who didn't know it, oh, Kurt, no, Marianne, all the way, buddy. I'm sorry, couldn't go for that floozy ginger. But anyways, most of you probably know this little piece of trivia on that song. When the first season came out, the song ended the movie star and all the rest. They just skipped the professor and Marianne as if they didn't even have a role. So that wasn't going to fly, and they changed that, I think, within the first season. Those are back when the shows, I think, were still black and white. So, all right. This next one, everybody knows it. Everybody's going to know it. It is probably the most well-known song in all of the industrial world. Unless you're a third world nation that don't have electricity and don't have a television, they know this song. So you can just kind of go right along with me if you would, all right? Hopefully. Thanks for joining us. Yeah, I'm with you, Paul. Marianne with the killer shorts.
You didn't sing.
I know. Well, that was what I was going to get at. Diane came out, always the critic, to remind me. That is the Andy Griffith Show. Everybody knows that. But what a lot of people probably don't know is that there are actually words to that song. And if you, it's not that it's a big secret. If you Google it, yeah, thanks, Nancy. If you Google it, there are, the words are out there, which is where I've got, and there's actually a copy of Andy Griffith singing that song. And so, since none of you know it, you won't know how badly I do it, I'm going to do the same song, this time with the words. Well, now take down your fishing pole and meet me at the fishing hole. We may not get a bite all day, but don't you rush away. What a great place to rest your bones, a mighty fine for skipping stones. We'll feel fresh as a lemonade, a setting in the shade. Whether it's hot, whether it's cool, oh, what a spot for whistling like a fool. What a fine day to take a stroll and wander by the fishing hole. I can't think of a better way to pass the time of day. We have no need to call the roll, and when we get to the fishing hole, then there'll be you and me, an old dog tree, to do old time away. If we don't hook a perch or bass, we'll cool our toes in dewy grass, or else pull up a weed to chaw and maybe set and jaw. Hanging around, taking our ease, watching that hound, scratching at his fleas. Come on down to the fishing pole and meet me at the fishing hole. I can't think of a better way to pass the time of day. All Yay! Right. Thank you, Lisa. Yeah, I know, Paul, it will never be the same after you've heard me sing it. All right, there we go. Hey, Gail, thanks for coming. So, guys, hope those of you who have been with me before know I don't take myself too serious. I hope you don't take this too serious. I want you to have fun. If you want to laugh, that's fine. Go ahead and laugh. We just I'm not out for any Grammys just in any way, shape, or form. We're just having a good time. Hey, Guru, gotcha. All right. All right. So this was a short one. Hopefully you guys will remember this. As a young boy, this show got the motor rolling, let me tell you. And other young boys will understand what we were young then, will understand what I'm talking about. Come around, a little train that is rolling down the tracks at the junction. Forget about your cares, it is time to relax at the junction.
Petticoat Junction.
It's a curve, you bet. Even more when you get to the junction.
Petticoat Junction.
There's a little hotel called the Shady Rest at the junction.
Petticoat Junction.
It is run by Kate, come be her guest at the junction.
Petticoat Junction.
And that's Uncle Joe, he's a moving kind of slow at the junction. Petticoat Junction. There you go. Diane told me she was not going to do that, and then she snuck it in on me afterwards. Well, I guess it's only fair. I've snuck it in on her a few times before, too, so never mind. This is supposed to be a kid show. All right. So, moving on up through the years and the decades and TV shows that we all watched and enjoyed, and I know there's going to be a gazillion of them that I've missed. There were a couple of them, I'm going to tell you right now, that were on my idea. Yeah, that was Diane's singing debut. Sort Jim Davidson asked if that was Diane's singing debut. So I had a couple songs that I was going to do, and I really liked them, but I was not able to do them very well. I apologize. So I rotated them out for some other ones. They're still TV songs. So this is not one of them. This was one that was on there originally. And you could not do a TV medley and not have this one. You had to have the Andy Griffith Show, and you got to have this one. Sunday, Monday, happy days. Tuesday, Wednesday, happy days. Thursday, Friday, happy days. Friday, Saturday, what a day, rocking all week with you. These days are all, won't you be mine? These days are all, oh please be mine. Goodbye, gray sky, hello blue. There's nothing can hold me when I hold you. Richie Cunningham must have been the key to both of those songs. And Diane was covering her ears, so I obviously need a little liquid vibration to get it going here.
Yeah, that's kind of straight.
as Jackie Gleason used to say, wah. Woo, that was good stuff. Alrighty. The next one, I've actually got the wrong colored Kepi on for this one, but that's okay. We're gonna play this.
All Kepis matter.
All Kepis matter, that's right. We're going to play this song because probably going to be outlawed here in any time near the future. That was good. Here we go. Wow, Brad Hennigan. Hey, Brad. Thanks for joining. Just some good old boys, never meaning no harm. Beats all you ever saw. They've been in trouble with the law since the day they were born. Straight in the curve, flat on the hill. Someday the mountain might get them, but the law never will. Making their way any way they know how. That's just a little bit more than the law will allow. I'm a good old boy, you know my mama loved me, but she don't understand. They keep showing my hands and not my face on TV. Just some good old boys, never meaning no harm. Beats all you ever saw. Been in trouble with the law since the day they were born. All right, Dukes of Hazzard. Yep, the General Lee. So we gotta get that in while we can, because that's obviously gonna go away. So, Kurt, you would appreciate this in a way. This is kind of a little bit had you in mind for this song. This was a this was one of the songs that I dropped, but I want to, let's see if you guys can figure it out. It's considered a Vietnam song, but it actually came out after Vietnam, and it was used on a TV show about Vietnam called Tour of Duty. Let's see if I can get the opening riff, and then you'll be able to know what I'm talking about. That's why I'm not doing that one. All right, so I couldn't do Paint It Black by the Stones for the TV show Tour of Duty.
Maybe in two weeks.
I'll keep working on it. We'll see how it turns out. But it's some of these things are a little tougher than they look. So instead of Tour of Duty, we'll go to a comedy show instead. Although he was a Marine, so we'll talk about the Drew Carey Show. And this was the theme song from that. Up every morning just to keep a job. I gotta find my way through the hustle and mob. Sounds of the city pounding in my brain while another day goes down the drain. But there's a 5 o'clock world when the whistle blows. No one owns a piece of my time. Every time my baby smiles at me, BJ, thank you for joining me from Puerto Rico. All right, Kurt's giving me his life story over there. All right, I loved the Drew Carey Show. It was one of my favorite TV shows when it was on. I thought it was funny. Everything about it was good. And I had marked my pages, and there they are. All right. Okay. So we're into the 80s. Lots of good shows that were playing there. Most of us were done with school and living our lives and trying to pretend like we were grown-ups.
Cranking out babies.
Yeah, well, that's the part of pretending we were grown-ups part. So let's see if you guys can get with this one. Have to do this show if you're going to do TV shows. Making your way in the world today takes everything you got. Taking a break from all your worries sure would help a lot. Wouldn't you like to get away? All of those nights when you got no lights, the check is in the mail, and your little angel hung the cat up by its tail. Your third fiancé didn't show. Sometimes you wanna go where everybody knows your name, and they're always glad you came. You wanna be where you can see, troubles are all the same. You wanna be where everybody knows your name. Mr. Coffee's dead, morning's looking bright, and your shrink ran off to Europe, didn't even write. And your husband wants to be a girl. Those are words. Be glad there's one place in the world where everybody knows your name. Yes, it is. Well, it could be sidelines. When I got out of the service and I moved to New Hampshire, I worked in downtown Boston, and the pub or the bar that was used for Cheers was called the Bull and Finch Pub, and it's right there on the corner by the Boston Botanical Gardens. And they had the sign out, and it looked just like on the TV show with the sidewalk and everything. And I went inside there, and it ain't nothing the same. It was completely different. So that was a little bit of a disappointment. And nobody knew who the hell I was. Nobody knew my name, so I got out of there. So
and headed straight to the split banana.
I headed straight to no the
oh ho ho the golden banana.
The golden banana. That's right, up on Route 1 in Peabody, Massachusetts. If for those of you who are up there, you would know. All right, thank you, Nancy, for the update. So as you know, every show or every week, I do at least one Beatles song. Kurt has put that bug in my ear, and I've done to it. And it was very difficult to try to find a Beatles song that was used for a TV show. I had two of them, as a matter of fact. One of them was for the Beatles cartoon show, and I didn't want to use that one. But there was another Beatles song that was used for a different TV show. And Kurt, type real quick, see if you know what that was. I'll even tell you. The name of the song was Lady Madonna. But what TV show was that used on? Anyone?
There's a 3-minute delay.
Bueller? Anyone? All right, I'll tell you anyways. Lady Madonna, the Beatles, was used on the TV show Grace Under Fire. And I got the song down pretty good, but there was one line and there were some chord changes that I just can't get to make them sound really decent. So I hung off on that. And instead, I'm going to use a Beatles song. I've done it once before, but that's okay. I can do it again. And this one was used in the Beatles cartoon, which ran from 1965 through 1967, three seasons. And this was the theme song for that cartoon show. I can't buy me love. I might have off in the wrong key to start with.
Yes, you are.
Can't buy me love. Lower.
Oh, don't look at me.
Thanks. You're not, Diane's no help.
The dogs aren't crying yet.
Well, they will be in here shortly. Sorry. Joel, sorry you came in at this moment. But if you fix me a drink, I'm sure it'll get better. Oh, wait. There we go. It may only be better in my head. Can't buy me love. Nope, that's not it either. Can't buy me love. There we go. Can't buy me love. Love. Can't buy me love. Buy you diamond ring, my friend. It makes you feel alright. Give you everything, my friend. Much for money, money can't buy me love. I give you all I got to give if you say you love me too. May not have a lot to give, but what I got, I'll give to you. I don't care too much for money, money can't buy me love, can't buy me love. Everybody tells me so, can't buy me love. For money, money can buy me love, can buy me love. Everybody tells me so, can buy me love. No, 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 no. Say I don't need no diamond rings, now be satisfied. Tell me that you want the kind of things money just can't buy. I don't care too much for money. Money can't buy me love, can't buy me love, love, can't buy me love. All right, there we go. For better or worse, and maybe worse, that's what you get. All right, like I've told other people before, you know what? You got what you paid for. I do have a song coming up here in a minute that I'm not going to tell you what it is. You're just going to have to suffer through and hear it. And the first person who is able to guess it and type it down will get my undying admiration. That's about the best I can do for you right now. This is not the one. It's the next song. So see if you can get this one. One of the most popular shows on TV until it was surpassed by The Big Bang Theory, which, by the way, I tried that one, and there's no way in heck I'm doing that one for at least a while. All right, let's see here.
So no one told you life was gonna be this way. Job's a joke, you're broke, your love life's DOA. It's like you're always stuck in second gear. Well, it hasn't been your day, your week, your month, even your year. But I'll be there for you when the rain starts to pour. Thank you.
And your brother got that first.
Ah, all right.
Suck up.
Friends, he knew that one only because he has none. That's why. All right. If you know this next song, you are a true geek.
Nerd alert. A forking nerd.
What the frack? And that is not the answer. All right, let's see if you can get this one. Take my love, take my land, take me where I cannot stand. I don't care, 'cause I'm still free. You can't take the sky from me. Take me out to the black, tell them I ain't coming back. Burn the land, boil the sea, you can't take the sky from me. There's no place that I can be since I've found serenity. That's it. Oh, Lynn Davidson got it.
Nerd.
But that's okay. She nailed it. You didn't cheat and look at my cheat sheet when you guys were over here, did you? So, all right. We're getting down to the end.
The painful end.
We're getting down to the end, and this is where I could almost hear the applause when I said that right then through the phone. So, you're in for a real treat tonight. Our last TV show, and it's going to be a duet. And it's amazing when we looked at this and we looked at the actual words that, again, they seem to be, okay, Lynn, they seem to be pretty appropriate for today. So, Diane is going to join me.
Sorry, guys.
Clip it good. Okay, you're not going to see her, though. She refuses to be on camera.
I'm getting that from Lenny.
Right, but you're gonna stand up or you're gonna just stay there? Okay, remember you're the orange and we're both the green.
Okay.
Right? Boy, the way Glenn Miller played
songs that made the head parade.
Guys like us, we had it. Those were the days. Didn't need no welfare state.
Everybody pulled his weight.
Gee, our Oldsmobile ran great.
You fucked that
those
up.
Those were the days.
You skipped all that.
We didn't do that part. We were up here.
Race.
We're going to start all over because Diane can't read music, apparently. You ready?
No.
You ready, Edith? Oh, it's stifle! All
right.
Jeez, Edith. Ready? We're going to do it again.
Come on,
Gene. Oh, shut up. Oh, Jesus. Boy, the way Glenn Miller played.
Songs that made the hit parade.
Boys like us, we had it. Those were the days. Didn't need no welfare state.
Everybody pulled his weight.
Gee, our Oldsmobile ran great.
Those were the days. And you knew who you were then.
Girls were girls and men. Man,
Mister, we could use a man like Ronald Reagan again.
People seem to be content.
$50 paid the rent.
Freaks were in the circus tent.
Those were the days.
Dodgers win.
Have yourself a dandy day that cost you under a fin.
Hair was short and skirts were long.
Kate Smith really sung the song.
I don't know just what went wrong.
Those were the days. Whoa, that was painful.
Oh, that hurt. Oh, jeez, you get in the kitchen and make me something. All right. Wow, Ryan, you actually guessed that one. Okay. Let me see, I think when we watched all of, as Ma would say, all of Mullen the Family, that was, I think you might have been in Okinawa a lot when we were watching that. All right. So, folks, that is actually all of the TV shows, but I did have a request for a song. Jim or Lynn, do you know if Tal is watching? Do I need to do this one? Thank you, Mary. Do I need to do this last song for them, or just go ahead and do it anyways?
Do it anyway. And then we're going to do a special thing for Jim Davidson.
Oh, we're going to do the whole family sing-along right afterwards. You ready? So this was a, yeah, you're right, Ron, that was Pa's favorite show. And I understood why, because he was very much like Archie, and I'm turning into it as well. All right, here we go. Let's see. Maybe a whistle.
Cry. I watch them grow. They'll learn much wake up where the clouds are far behind.
Because they're all asleep.
Well, all the dogs are asleep, but we're going to try to see if we can't get them to do a sing-along for the adios. And it's sort of like the end of the Lawrence Welk show. And a one, and a two. Sing-along. We don't know if Tripp doesn't like it and it hurts his ears or if he's trying to sing along with us, but that's it for the show for tonight. Yeah, you're right. The show has gone to the dogs, Barbara. Hope you guys all had a good night and enjoyed it, even with all the screw-ups and everything else. I've decided to do this every other week, so I won't be here next week. Maybe trying to figure out some new things and put something together. Hopefully get a little bit more practice and be better at this. But bottom line is I hope it was entertaining for tonight and you guys had a couple of good laughs. And take care. Talk to you soon. Bye.